them time and you're going through Kinder, okay, these guys. Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I'm sorry that I look so crusty, like I'm actually studying, so right now is my study break, so I quickly like figured that I should squeeze, you know, filming this video into my study break. Because you guys have been asking me like to, you know, share my study tips with you guys, so I'm finally doing that. So okay guys, without wasting any time, first of all, right, if you want to achieve good grades, you need to be organized. Like, you need to be super organized, guys. Like, that really helps you a lot. So what I do to make sure that I'm organized, right, so what I do to make sure that I'm organized, I have like things like this, right? These, I don't know what you call them. Is that pocket folders or whatever, you know? I have things like this for like all of my subjects, right? So I also have one like this. This is for my English. As you can see, it says English Poetry Grade 12, Mrs. Y. Bester. That's my teacher, right? So I have like folders like this for all of my subjects. I have for English, Afrikaans, Sesotho, because I also use Sesotho as an extra subject, for math, for geo, life science, business. So I have folders like this for all of my subjects, and this really helps because in these folders are all of my notes from the whole year, question papers, past question papers, you know, everything, even summaries that I make, summaries that I get from like the internet, that I get from my teacher, that I get from anywhere, because literally, like, I try to compile as many notes for all of my subjects as possible. So yeah, you need to get organized. So if you're gonna get organized, please get yourself like these folders. And for your subjects where you have like a lot of notes, you want to get yourself this one, because this one is like very strong. It can take like a lot of papers and stuff. So yeah, please get organized. And then okay, so first of all, you need to be organized, right? And guys, also, like, when you are about to study, please make sure that you have all of your notes in order so that you don't waste time. Because if you are studying and you don't have all of your notes in order, you're going to waste so much time. Because while you're studying, you need to quickly stop and go look for this paper. You have to go look for this question paper. You have to go fetch these summaries in your other, in your bag, you know, whatever. So please make sure that you're all organized when you're studying so that you don't waste time. Because time is very important when you're studying. So first of all, you must get organized, right? Second of all, please make sure that you have like study books for all of your subjects, right? So I have study books like this for all of my subjects, hard covers. So I have one for business studies, and then this is for life science, and then I have one for business studies. Okay, then in these books, like, I compile all of my notes, right? My paper one notes are in the front, my paper two notes are at the back, and then at some point, like in the middle of my book, I have something like this where I say possible essays, and then I just write like possible essay questions, you know, how to answer them and stuff. And then also in my business study book, it's the same thing. But remember, in business studies, right, you don't answer all the questions. So in my notes, I only make notes about the questions that I answer. So I don't answer legislation. So I answer like I think it's called business environments. I don't answer that question. I only answer the questions based on like creative thinking, you know, things like your miscellaneous topics, so they ask you about everything. But by the miscellaneous topics, I only answer the things that I know. So I answer like answer question 3, 4, and 6 in business studies. So in this book, right, I only like summarize notes based on question 3, 4, and 6. And then I have books like this for geography, for pure math, for English as well, because in English I make notes like on my poems and, you know, everything I need to know about literature, even like things that I need to know for the language paper, you know. And then I have one like this for Afrikaans as well, for all of my subjects, literally for all of them. And then you want to get your hand on like a good study guide. So I have like a lot of these study guides, right? So I use these study guides by Answer Series. So I have one for business, I have two for life science. Let's see, So I have two for life science. I have for life science paper one and for life science paper two. Then I have one like this for English. And this one, guys, is very important because I have one for English home language and English first additional language. So if you're in matric, please get your hands on this, guys, because it literally gives you like everything you need to know, all the formats. You know, like if it's paper three, also it gives you like everything that you need to know for paper one. Literally everything. It is so important. And then yeah, but guys, the thing is with the life science study guide, right, like this, I don't use it that much because it gives like a lot of extra information that I don't necessarily need to know. So I use the Mind the Gap study guide for life science more than I use this one of answer series, because that one is compiled based on the examination guidelines. So they don't give you extra information, they literally just like tell you what you need to know, you know, based on the examination guidelines. So please, guys, get your hands on like a study guide like this, maybe the answer series one or the Mind the Gap for life science and for math as well as for physics. And very recently I think they have one for geo now, so you can get your hands on like a study guide of Mind the Gap for life science, mathematics, physics and geo, and also English, right? Yeah, but for my other subjects, for math and life science I use the Mind the Gap, but then for my other subjects I use this answer series. So for business I use answer series, for English I use answer series, and for geo I use the answer series because I feel like those are the best. So please, guys, get your hands on like a good study guide, because it will literally take you very far, because you can't just use your textbooks. And I've never used any of the textbooks that my school supplies me with to study, because yeah, they're not helpful. I prefer study guides all the time. And then, guys, you want to get your hands on past question papers, like as many past question papers as possible. So I have past question papers from 2015 until 2018, and I literally use them, guys. Like, you can get past question papers on Parent24, it's a website, right? But I think it's only like for matric. But yeah, if you're in grade 11, you can get past question papers from your teachers. But with your past question papers, right, you must first study and then go through your things. So for example, let's say if I'm doing maths, right, so I use my Mind the Gap study guide for math, right? And then let's say I'm focusing on functions today, so I make sure that I cover everything in my study guide based on functions. Then once I know everything, I look at my question papers from 2015 until 2018, and then in those question papers of those 3 years, I only answer the questions based on functions. And that also gives me an indication of whether I know functions or don't I know it, and that also tells me what I need to go and focus on, you know. So yeah, please get question papers for like all of your subjects, and please use them, guys. Like, that's literally like the best thing you can do to yourself. So first of all, you must get organized, so get your plastic folders, you know, to put all of your notes in. Number two, get like your hardcover books for all of your subjects so that you can like make your physical notes. Then get your study guides. And then number four, please get past question papers. Like, that will really help you. And then so with a subject like math, even Mathlet, you'll need to practice every single day, because I know Mathlet is easy, but you need to get like at least 70% for it to be considered. 68% is not good enough for Mathlet, so please make sure you get like 70%, and the only way you'll get that is if you practice like as much as possible, you know, you do your homework, stuff like that. And even with math, so guys, with maths and Mathlet, you need to do like a few sums every single day. Like, if you go to bed without doing maths, even if you just did like one sum, then you are literally shooting yourself in the foot, let me tell you. So with that, you'll need to like do maths every single day. And then with your literature, right, for English and Afrikaans, that's why it's also good to use past question papers. So what I usually do is I go back to like 2015, right? So with us, we do Life of Pi in English, and those 12 poems, and also our drama is The Crucible, right? So I look at my past question papers, I go through them, and I see, okay, so in 2015 they ask these two themes of Life of Pi, in 2016 they ask the other two themes, in 2017, you know, just like that, until 2018. And then because our teacher like gave us all the notes you need to know in Life of Pi and the different themes, I know, okay, so I only need to focus on these other themes, because they've already asked the other themes, you know, like that. And then even with the poems, I look, okay, from 2015 until 2018, they've asked 6 poems. So I know from the list of 12 poems that I need to know, I don't need to know those 6 because they've already asked them and there's no way they're asking them again. So I only focus on the other 6, right? But you need to know all of them. That's how you must like study every single day, so you can go through all of your poems, like, you know, all of them before the exam comes. And then before the exam, you'll only focus on the ones that you think they are going to ask you based on like the past question papers that you've been through. Yeah, and then that's also what I do for Afrikaans. And then yeah, that's basically it in essence. Okay, then when it comes to the actual studying, you know, I study verbally, but I also study like by writing. So I would write down my notes and then I must read them out loud and explain them to myself, and I must move around. That's the only way the things actually go into my head. So you must find out what your study style is. But let me tell you, if you just read, you're just reading like a parrot, it's not going to go into your head. So you must write it down. That's how you need like notebooks. And when it comes to writing down, please make sure that you like write in a blue pen, because guys, blue pens help, like a navy blue pen, not black. Nah, it helps for you to like remember properly apparently. And just make sure that you have like highlighters or color pens, because it's good to use color while you are studying, because it just helps you to, you know, remember things better. And it's good to see color like while you're studying, because so that you don't just see black or blue the whole time, because that's very boring. And then and then what else? Okay, so your actual studying, right, when you're actually studying, please drink a lot of water, guys. When you are studying, you need to drink a lot of water. Water is so good for you, and it helps you, like, it gives you energy as well, and it just helps your brain to function, like, you know, very well. So while you're studying, you need to drink like a lot of water. Usually I drink like 8 cups of water, but when I'm studying I drink like 12. So you need to drink a lot of water, and ice water, like water that's ice cold, water that has ice, you know, ice cubes inside. That really helps. And then make sure that the area where you study is very neat, please, because if it's messy, it's going to be very difficult for you to study well, because your notes are going to get lost and you're going to have to first look for your notes, and that also wastes time, you know. So yeah, please make sure that your study area is neat. And if you are in your study area, please make sure that there's adequate lighting. Make sure that you're in a room where it's bright, where there are windows, and you get a lot of sunlight, you know. And also please get your hands on a study lamp, guys. Like, a study lamp is very crucial, especially if you study at night, because then it helps that you see clearly, you know, because you can't study like under dim light. That's not good. And then guys, you want to actually study in the morning hours, like between 2 o'clock and 5 o'clock, because of that time of the morning, you know, that time of the day, actually your brain functions at its best. So please, let's say what I usually do, right, if I go to school, I get home at around 4, but now I don't go to school anymore, I'm just like preparing for exams. So yeah, I would study during the day as much as possible, right? I study, 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 then I make sure, okay, at 9 o'clock I'm done studying there. And then if I feel like, okay, but I still want to do a bit of math or a bit of life science, or you know, whatever, then I wake up, I'd go to bed at like 9, 10 o'clock latest. So then I wake up at around, I sleep for 10, 11, 12, 1, 2, 3. I wake up at like 3. So that's 5 hours of sleep, which is enough for me. So then I study for like from 3 o'clock, I study until like 5, and then at 5 o'clock I go to bed again, or sometimes I go to bed at 6, and then I wake up later on again at like 9 or 10, and then I study again, just like that. And that really works for me. Like when I study at that time of the day, I really remember very well. So please guys, but if you can't study you know, very early in the morning, if you know that you can't wake up, then don't do it. Just try to study as much as possible, you know, throughout the day until the evening. And guys, it is important to like sleep early ish because yeah, especially the day before the exam, you don't want to sleep like at 12 o'clock and then you wake up at 4 o'clock and study again. You want to do that the day before exam. That's why you must study in advance, so you can like, you know, sleep at random hours, and then the day before the exam you can actually sleep for 8 hours, you know, get proper rest. And then also the day of exam, please make sure that you eat proper breakfast. But don't eat a full breakfast, like don't eat the food from last night, you know, your pap and your chicken, because a full meal, you can't eat a full meal when you're writing exam, because then all your blood is going to go to your stomach, you know, trying to digest the food instead of to your brain. So when you are writing exam, please eat like proper breakfast. Just maybe eat cereals or like eggs and bread, and drink coffee, you know. Don't eat like a full meal. And yeah, drink a lot of water before the exam starts. Drink a lot of water because that's really good. But don't drink water during the exam because then you're gonna pee a lot. And if you do drink a lot of water before the exam, then like before the exam starts, you know, you're gonna get like that 15-minute break or whatever where you guys can like go to the bathroom and stuff, switch off your phone and stuff. So during that time, just go to the bathroom. Even if you don't need to pee, just go to the bathroom, especially if you know that you drank a lot of water, so you don't waste time during you know, the examination time going to the bathroom. Yeah, that's basically it, guys. Also, y'all, on the day of the exam, please arrive early, like 30 minutes early, I swear, because things can go wrong in the morning, guys. And if you go and write an exam and you get there late, and now wada, there's also problems with the question paper, like that's going to waste so much of your time. And you know, after, oh my word, you know, okay, this first, after like your 3 hours, they don't give you extra time. So please make sure she get there on time so she can like fix any mistakes that might have happened, you know, earlier on. And then make sure that you have your own stationery, guys, because during the exams you cannot borrow. Even if you're allowed to at your school, it wastes a lot of time, because now while you're writing, you need to put up your hand and ask the invigilator to come to you, and you tell her, oh ma'am, my pen's not working, can you please borrow a pen for me? And she has to say, okay guys, please stop writing, can you guys please borrow a pen? Then now you're disturbing everyone, everyone has to stop writing just for, you know, that wastes a lot of time. So please make sure that you have your own stationery. Make sure that you have like 3 pens, not 2, because sometimes both of your pens don't want to work. Make sure you have an eraser, you have a pencil, a sharpener, extra pencil, a ruler. Yeah, that's literally all you need, and a color pen. I like to write in color pen, you know, just like I write, okay, question 2 in a color pen, and then under that I write in the blue. Like all of my questions, I write them in color pen, because I don't know, I just like it when my question paper looks, you know, cute and neat. And then in your question paper, please write neatly. Because guys, that will really help you. Like, if you write untidy, yo, but you're smart, then you'll end up getting bad marks. Because if the person that's marking your script can't read what you're saying, then they just like, they'll assume, okay, this person is saying this, or they'll just assume that whatever you said is wrong. So please do write neatly. I mean, yeah, I think that's all, guys. I think I've covered everything. Oh, yeah. Study every single day, guys. I know studying every single day seems like it's very boring, but at the end of the day, it's going to pay off. Like, study every single day during your school terms, that during the holiday you can enjoy your holiday, you know, and your parents won't have a problem if you leave on Saturday and you come back the next week Wednesday, because they know, no, my child worked very hard during the term, you know. So study every single day, you know, and studying every single day really helps, because when it's time of the exam, you don't need to cover a lot of work, because you know you've covered most of it throughout the term already. So what I usually do is, like, when I get home from school, I go through the work that we did that day at school, you know, during class time. Then I go through and I make sure that I know it perfectly. Then when it's the time of the test, I don't even have to study it because I already studied it that time, you know. And then, yeah, do your homework, guys. Doing your homework is so important, because when you do your homework, you're actually studying. Because remember, you are doing a question. If you get it wrong and you guys are doing corrections the next day, you see, oh, okay, this is the answer. So, you know, that's the form of you learning, and you're able to ask your teacher questions like, oh, ma'am, I said this and this and this, but why is it wrong? Then she'll explain to you, and, you know, that's also how you learn. Yo, so please do your homework, guys. That's very important. You need to do your homework every single day, no matter what, no matter what. So if you are going through a tough time during exams, man, please just like put it aside, guys. I know it might be difficult, but please try to, you know, not focus on your problems, because exams are very important. So y'all, you'll need to like just like put your things aside. If you're going through a tough time, just, you know, pray to say, God, please help me. Like, I don't want to be distracted by this. Can you please just, you know, help me to focus? You'll deal with whatever it is after you are done with your exams, because you can't afford to be distracted by like small things, because it's really, you know, it's your future. And then yeah, guys, that's basically it. Please, when it's your exam time, like, do not stress, okay? Don't stress like when you're studying for GO and thinking, oh no, tomorrow I'm writing business, the day after I'm writing life science. Just focus on the subject that you're writing the next day, like, and study for it as best as you can, and then you'll be fine. So another thing, do not study if you are very tired. If you're very tired, then just take a nap, but don't sleep for 3 hours. That's not a nap, that's sleeping. Take a nap for like an hour to 2 hours. That's it. After 2 hours, you have to wake up. Even if you feel like you're still tired or you haven't slept for that long, just wake up, you like drink a lot of water and you'll just like quickly take a walk outside, you know, in the yard, and then you'll be fine, literally. And yeah, please don't stress. Don't stress. Just study every single day and pray, and God will literally do the rest, and you'll see it will really pay off. And when you do study, you need to pray. Yo, guys, when you are studying, you must pray. Especially if you wake up at like, you know, 3 o'clock in the morning to study, because you know at 3 o'clock the spirits are loose and whatever. So you, when you wake up, you must, first thing you do, you pray. You just say, God, thank you so much for waking me up. Father God, please bless and protect me as I'm about to study. Please ease the pounding of my heart, relax my mind, you know, that I'm not too stressed, so that everything can just come in, you know, get into my mind, and I can remember everything, and just please be with me, please give me strength, you know, Father God. And when I write this exam tomorrow, please make me calm, help me to answer the questions to the best of my ability, you know. Thank you, God, thank you for everything. I just say thank you to him, and you'll be fine, I swear, because that's what I do. And look where I am now. I got distinctions for English, Afrikaans, maths, you know, everything. So yeah, literally, that's all you guys need to know. And yeah, I hope you find my tips helpful. And another note, guys, I won't be posting like on YouTube for a very long time because it is exams, but I'll give you guys like a live update as time goes. And if I do post, please make sure that you put on your post notifications, because I also won't be active on Instagram, so I won't be able to tell you guys whenever I'm posting on the gram, you know. I won't be able to tell you guys in my stories that, okay, I'm gonna post tonight at 7 o'clock. So yeah, please make sure that your post notifications are on, that you are notified whenever I post on my YouTube channel. And yeah, guys, I love you guys. Good luck with your exams. And please just relax. Take it easy one day at a time. Don't put yourself under too much pressure. And I swear you'll be okay. I love you guys. Good luck. Until next time.